In this video, I will show you a device that will give you high precision solder stencil printing for under $5. I've been working a lot on trying to solve this problem of getting accurate and precise solder stencil for quite some time. I've built many devices, some more complex than others, like this 5-axis machine for framed solder stencils that you can control with a PS4 controller. And this smaller manual one for frameless stencils. But I never shared it openly with everyone. That was until I met this guy.
Hi, I'm Seon, the Unexpected Maker.
Once I started to share my projects with Seon, it turned out we kind of had the same problem in our designs. We started to work together and share our progress. And after about a week, there were leaps of progress to show. We both had machines that were struggling to get the solder stencil completely flat on the PCB. And if the solder stencil is not completely flat on the PCB, the solder paste can very easily spill out under the side of the solder stencil. Seon suggested we should use some kind of vacuum bed. And to me, it made perfect sense to use just a normal vacuum cleaner. A vacuum cleaner has extremely high flow rate compared to vacuum venturis and piston pumps. And that is something most people already have at home. The goal of this channel is to make making stuff more accessible for everyone everywhere. So a normal vacuum cleaner was the perfect solution. After a few iterations with vacuum beds, I realized that I could just drop my entire machine if I could add one more extra technological phenomena to the vacuum bed. The ability of a flexible object to store energy. Or as normal people would say, let's add spring to it so they can lift the solar stencil automatically. Now, let's assemble the latest version of this device so you can learn how it works.
Add your circuit board to the box and then put on the solder stencil and then align it. After that, you turn on the vacuum and then you align it for a last time. Then put on your solder paste, then scrape it over and off. Now let's turn off the vacuum and see how it pops off.
The results impressed me a lot, and you can see that it has given very good precision. But if you look under a microscope, you see that accuracy here could be better. This will eventually come down to the operator moving the stencil around. Not a single thing in the world will ever be perfect. But in the next episode of the solder stencil saga, to get better accuracy, I need to add some complexity to the machine. By adding a controllable bypass valve to the vacuum connector. This way, it should be more easy to move the stencil around, because it's gonna suck less, making it more accurate. If you want to follow my progress as I work on this project, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, or my YouTube livestream channel. Or you can just wait for the next video to show up on this channel. This design will be open source, and I will be sharing the Fusion 360 files. I have also added this project as a Hackaday project. Links are in the description. Now, I'm really surprised that it all came down to such a simple solution for fixing the solar stencil problem, and I'm really happy I was able to work together with Seon. So a big thanks to you, Seon, for pushing me to finish this project together with you, and for sharing ideas, fail prints along the way. Seon has some really cool products over at unexpectedmaker.com, so go check them out. And on this upcoming Tuesday, me and Seon will be doing a live stream on his channel where we talk about why we like to build our own versions of things that already exists. I leave a link to his channel in the description. Ha det bra! Ses neste gang!